So we begin to know what is the extension. Let us know why we need this. A solution for the problems. You know, some people know me as can express it like this. A1, 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 No, so if you have class of polynomials,
say P of X.
When you have two in R, you need one of them.
also need one. When you have three, then half you also need one over three. Also, yeah. But this type of R with this property is called filled.
The stars can be filled in the solution set. As they,
so, but then
the solution set can be at least this.
But you may have other solutions which are more than this. Because these are rational numbers, you may have irrational solutions. You may even have complex solutions. Look at that. Which, what it means is that you have to keep extending your field of solution, depending on the polynomial you are confronted with. So that's what I have discussed in the first field extension we have here. So one we said, suppose you have a polynomial like this, x minus 1, so like this, y equals 2, you know the solution set. You expect you are operating within the field of rationals. Field of rationals. Our polynomial sets are what? You know what solution you ask yourself. Can I have a solution? And it turns out you cannot. Because at least the solution set here is x minus 1. Which is not because x is equal to 1. So that's not the number to do. So that means your solution set is not in the field of rationals. So what do you do? What do you want to accommodate the solution set in the numbers? Suppose you are doing some research and you end up with a polynomial in your research and you want to find a solution in this polynomial, you find out that the solution of that polynomial of yours does not belong to the field of rationals. So what do you do to accommodate the solutions? You want to give your report, your results. You extend. You are going to extend. You are going to extend the solution set. For example, if this is your, supposing this is your field Q, you may wish to extend it. This is where the solution set. So you need to extend it to something else here. Maybe Q dash or whatever. Or let me call it E. According to my previous session. So you extend this field to E. E is bigger. That means there are some numbers here which are not within these solutions. Yes. So, and when you do like this, we say you have extended your solution set. And you are not going to be completely extended.
That's what you discussed in your notes. And what we try to do is to say that. You can accommodate this. For example, you know, in such inclusion, you know, we have to start with it. For example, Z is pertaining to the domain. And we know Q is containing R. And we also know that R is containing complex numbers. So it means for a solution set not here. We may likely go R and we say that resolution. But R is so big, it says that it's too large. So what you need to do is that, for example, you have considered this. Now go to Q and then look for an extension in Q which will just accommodate this and you are okay. You don't have to change the color. So if you look at, if you now introduce Q, if you just add onto Q something like this, A plus B. So in that case,
A, B, A, Q, A, B. So in that case, your solution is going to be something like this. Just A plus B. And by the time you take the multiplication table of all the A plus B or 2, you add them to this, you whatever it is, it will follow with it. Get a collectible of this. A plus B.
But A plus B,
that thing is going to be there. Okay. So, for some other number, just introduce this in your multiplication. For other members of the field, so this is Q, but you are adding something on the multiplication. Then by the time you compute this multiplication, the whole solutions of the equations of this form will be inside here. So you don't obtain, but this is not R. This is just Q. You are adding something onto maybe E dash. And this is enough for you to cover your solution. So when we do like this, then you say you have done field extension. The question then arises whether this thing you have now done, whether it is a field. Is it also a field, this addition you have done? Or does it still maintain the properties of the field, or is it different? Then what you do, if you like to prove that, you check the field properties. For example, is it commutative? Is A plus B into C plus B to the same as
C plus B?
So for example, of course it is, because all the A, B, C, Q are in Q. As a from commutativity of Q, this follows. Since Q is a field, does it have multiplicative members? This one does it have multiplicative members? Does that exist? C plus. Such that if you multiply it with C plus D, such that if you multiply, you'll get unit. So what you do is, so you check, I think by the time you check on this, you find out that it is actually a field. You check also associativity. I think that's one thing.
You know for sure that the real is contained in the calculus. P of complex numbers is of dimension 2.
You see the I
minus 1.
C minus 1.
Minus 9.
Jesus, I.
One.
Three.
One.
One. The next time will be I five. Minus one. So to look carefully, you have what? Plus or minus one? Plus or minus I? Is it? So already the same numbers here. I was it's one and one. That's all. Just basis. You may not worry about plus or minus because this is you are in vector space. Plus one is just the opposite of minus one. Yes. Imagine Z. When you say plus, you also mean minus because minus is what? Z. Negative or negative? It's different. You get plus. You say minus. Sorry, I know my friend, I just this and this. I just collapse and minus. So that's the basis of this. And that means the iota is the difference between the other complex and the center. This theory. The fundamentals theorem of physics. So, let there be a field, and I will say non constant polynomials. Let's have.
Thank you.
as of x equals on p of x into x. Now in E, we write f of x in E in the extension field E. We write like this. We write by the generators now. This is quotient field. Yeah. All this now. Few of x are the polynomials in f of x. So this one will generate set of polynomials in q of x. Remember, that set of polynomials should be in f of x. We have a quotient like this. So this behaving like a subset of this. Whatever polynomial that generates polynomial is a subset of the field of polynomials. So this is not like quotient ring. Just like we use some quotient rules, an element here was an element. So every element is expressible as what? F of x here, and then plus p of x. These are elements, step one of x, something like this. F of x1, f of x2, p of x2. These are elements here in this question. Then generate set of polynomials p of x. So therefore p of x is irreducible. I.e. p of x is irreducible. There's a list. It's irreducible in the least form. Now, what we do is we require about this quotient field to be as number one, we require it to be ideally generated, we shall require. This f of x by the generator to be ideal. Say field to be a field. With of x as ideal. Of course, ideal of f of x. So, the generator should be ideal. That means the generator of p of x is going to be an ideal of f of x. I will also require number two, also require that p of x divides p of x to b of x to imply that either p of x divides p of x or p of x will divide p of x. So we have said that p of x is irreducible. So it's either it divides p of x or it divides p of x.
Maybe phi. So that phi x f to e as an extension. So we are now having x here and we have an e. So we now map from the polynomials. And you want to say that those polynomials are zero here. the images of this also have zeros in the E. Good, and then now phi of A such that phi of A is defined as A plus remember what you have is your quotient rings, which I said are expressible like this. So if you have A here, then A plus here was a generator. So you take a polynomial here, phi of A, and you map it onto this. This is A plus because of the quotient rings. Remember, you have f of x. So, like this, by the generator group, we say the generator is.
So, this one will add on S. Phi of B will be B plus, phi of C will be C plus. This is like your this group, like your cosets. Good. Then, by our equation 1, we have f of x by the generator.
Since every
let me say M plus P of X. Or let me not, so I select let M plus ID. Let M plus P of X belongs to E. Then what does that mean? Then you take the pi inverse of P. Pi inverse of P. Oh. M plus by definition is going to be pi inverse of what? Of M. Isn't it? Plus what? Pi inverse of. But P of X is the generator. Isn't it? It's the generator. It's in E. So this is going to be simply pi inverse of M is going to be M. And plus zero, okay? This is actually because this is an ideal, it's not an element. And P of X is not an element. So this is going to be simply pi inverse of M. Since what? Since P of X is an ID. Isn't it? So it's not an element, it's an ID. It's called set, actually. So, but this is simply M. But M is actually where? M is in the field. So that means implies that this pi number is also defined, well defined. And since it is well defined, that means there are one of S in has zero. Also in E, because the two sets are isomorphic. So if P of S in our hypothesis, we assume P of S has a zero in the hypothesis. We are now saying that also has zero in E, and we are completed with E. So, and I think this is